Hey guys, what's up? Oh, I'm still sick. I fixed this HP laptop, by the way. I don't know if my camera's gonna focus in the YouTube capture app. I'm hoping that this is a somewhat presentable video when I'm done. So this is the HP Pavilion 17. Can't remember the exact model, but it's got a Core i5. DTS sound. Is that a plus? It's a plus. Owner put tape over the camera. Pretty typical. People who want to feel riskier. So it makes kind of sense. The shape? Something about HP and Toshiba seems really similar about their design. Like my, if you take a look up on the top, on the floating IKEA shelf over there, that thing, that's a Toshiba laptop. Now when you compare it to the general shape of this HP Pavilion model, I don't want to dump it onto the ground by accident, but you notice the similarities, don't you? Now unplug my iPad. There's quite a few similarities in the shape, isn't there? Yeah, there's even a dip in the trackpad there. In fact, the ports might even be on the same side. Nah, the disc tray is on the other side. Yeah, otherwise it's a pretty similar shape. HP Pavilion, though, is a much sexier looking machine. It's a strange statement to say about a computer, but honestly, I just like the appearance of it better. Runs Windows 10. It's designed for Windows 8.1. I just put in my own cheap little hard drive from the Acer Travel Mate. It's sitting over there for now. Well, my business buddy is getting it, ordering a little laptop hard drive. Seagate Ultra Fin, I believe it is. Momentous Ultra Fin. I believe it's a 500 gigabyte hard drive with 32 megabytes of cache. I thought it would probably be the best thing to replace what was in there. What was in there before was not the Toshiba. I mean, I don't want to. I know it's already broken and stuff, but I don't want it to get further broken or break something else in the table. But what was in there before was this HGST. I don't know if it's even going to focus for me. HGST. It's a SATA hard drive, as typical for most laptops. The only computer that I have that isn't a SATA drive is that HP Compaq over there. Well, not the one to the right, but the one to the left. The one that has just the charger cable on it, not the charger cable and the selfie stick with a blue handle. Don't ask me about that, I already told you. Oh, I sound rude now. I bought that at the dollar store for maybe $2 and I never really used it. I intended something for it. I kind of like this song. But anyways, this is a HGST hard drive. That one had a parallel ATA. That one. And so most laptops have serial ATA though. It's pretty common. What else? I was going to point something out about this hard drive. HGST Japan Limited. 750 gigabytes, 5400 RPM. Pretty typical drive, isn't it? For a laptop of this age, maybe 2013, I believe. It's got HP's typical light on the freaking wireless key, on the wireless key shortcut thing. It's got all their typical shortcuts for everything. You have to hold down the function key to get the normal functions to work. A little light behind the power button. Power is right to the right. Right to the right. There you go, guys. HDMI. HDMI. And then USB. Another USB. I believe those are both super speed. 3.0. And, headphone with microphone built in. So like, you know how earpods have a microphone built into the line? Well, it supports that for the microphone. And there's a little a SD card multi-reader whatever. I'm kind of tired, so don't blame me. Little LEDs. Go blinky blinky. Little disk drive, already slightly broken because this little panel here doesn't stick up anymore. The disk drive itself works, which is a good thing. There. See? That's what I mean. I didn't break it. That's actually how it was. Got my printer plugged into it. Kensington lock slot power. Small little power thing, proprietary as usual. Well, not really proprietary when you consider barrel style chargers. The only real proprietary barrel style charger was Apple's like PowerBook and iBook series, which used a barrel connector, which wasn't a typical one. I'll go into that maybe on a different video. If I ever do one, I will explain it to you guys. Ethernet, USB 2.0, not 3.0 on this side. What else? I believe this had Radeon graphics. I'm not sure. I mentioned it to one of my friends that it did, and I was sure at that time. Although now that I take a look at it again, I don't know. I'm gonna put this back on there. Printer. Something I was gonna mention it to you guys. Oh yeah, this little cheap ass cable I got at the dollar store for maybe $3. Tech one as usual. Typical cheap crap. It's nothing worth anything to mention. Got some new sanitary wipes. Ooh. I don't know why. I saw them and I was like, maybe these will be useful for cleaning stuff. There's the old Panasonic inverter. Screw that thing. And yeah, I microwaved some more stuff as you can see by the marks on the platter. I couldn't clean those off. Warning. Do not operate the oven empty. The microwave energy will affect continuously throughout the oven, causing overheating and damage. If food or water... Ooh, oh no. Oh no. You know what, I'll just consider that CE some food. There's something else I wanted to point out. Oh yeah, the other HP Compact D530. I got two of them. My own personal ones over there on that desk. It's got that floppy drive removed. This one's just a shell of a D530. The motherboard's in there and the power supply's in there. But otherwise, it's just a shell of a D530. It's empty for selling, because I don't need the other one. I was planning on keeping two of them, but what's the point? Besides, I could probably get a couple dollars for this thing. Oh, I'm still sick. Sorry, guys. I mentioned it to you before about the Acer TravelMate. Yeah, just a Corti Duo. Can't remember which model, because, you know, every time I say that, and every time you guys probably believe me, it's starting to get old. Someday I'll look it up. I should remember it off the top of my head. Poser audio speakers. Ooh, I point them out every time. I've been going through my box of crap. Cleaning that up. Sony subwoofer. You know, I'll be right back. I wanted to do something with that Sony subwoofer. I'll have a bit of fun with it, eh? Probably not even focused, is it? Whatever. Right now, it's just playing out of those little bookshelf things. It's nothing powerful. I'm gonna swap the input. Now nothing's playing, but just the headphones, which is technically the audio power meter. And I'm gonna turn it on to both subwoofers. You can hear how throaty that sound. Maybe throaty, I don't know what the term would be. Sony subwoofer from the home theater system? Yeah, the home theater. Here's where the power is at. Mm-hmm. camera, it doesn't take vibration of that cone very well. It thinks it needs to autofocus when I got it in so close. Well, there's my audio power meter doing its thing again. I wonder what would happen if I switched into high mode. Oh, it don't like that, does it? I'm gonna give it a bit more, just a right channel. Just out of a range of what I should be giving that little tiny speaker. It's maybe a 1.5 inch sub. And I'm giving it it's designed probably for maybe 5 watts. Cheap old crappy thing. And I'm probably giving it maybe 10. I don't know. 10's probably not an accurate estimate. I'm not good with audio power estimates. Oh, and by the way, the manual for this thing's over there. Oh, and if you want to know why I'm so high up now, it's because I'm standing on this case for the subwoofer. Yeah, I know it's probably going to break. Not really. This thing's actually pretty strong. I smashed it with a sledgehammer. Well, smash it? No, the sledgehammer just bounced off of it. That's how strong that thing is. I should have hit it more times to destroy it, but I didn't really want to destroy it. I just wanted to test its strength more like. Sorry. What else is gonna point out? Got my AM loop again, finally. Lent that to one of my friends, never gave it back until now. Allen key, empty external hard drive case. I wonder what radio sounds like on just a subwoofer. I don't think it would be the amp. It's a pretty high power amp, actually. Let me find something else to play on it. This kind of merged from a computer video to an audio video. I'm actually gonna end it here. Never mind. I might do some more screwing around with a subwoofer in a later video. Anyways, that's all I wanted to tell you guys. So, for that, until now, or until next time. Bye guys! Peace out. I gotta do my peace sign because I can't.